Storybox. We have a whole new series of stories, especially for Advent. Shall we have a look and see what is in the box? I have a candle. Now, I wonder what that's about. Advent. I wonder if you mark Advent at home. Do you have an Advent calendar? Do you open the doors every day to count down to Christmas? Well, in church, we also count down to Christmas, but we do it in a different way. We don't open a door every day. We count down with candles. We count down the weeks. So we count 4 weeks before Christmas. 1, 2, 3, 4. And on the fourth Sunday before Christmas, we call that the first Sunday of Advent. And we get an Advent wreath in our church. And if you don't know what an Advent wreath is, you might like to look that up and find out about it this week. And then we light the first candle on the Advent wreath. One candle for the first Sunday of Advent. Next week, on the second Sunday, we will be lighting two candles. But we'll leave that to next week. This week, let's think a little bit more about what Advent is all about. Because Advent is a strange word, isn't it? Advent is not even an English word. It comes from when people used to worship God in church, not in English, not even in Cornish, but in Latin. They even said the Lord's Prayer in Latin. So when they got to that bit in the Lord's Prayer where it says, "Thy kingdom come," they said it in Latin, which sounds totally different and uses different words. It sounded something like this. Adveniat regnum tuum. Adveniat, meaning let your kingdom come. Adveniat, let it come. Which we've shortened to Advent, to mean let it come. So Advent is about asking God for his kingdom to come on earth. Asking God to send his king back to earth. And Christmas is about remembering his king. Christmas we celebrate when Jesus came to earth and was born as a baby king. But when Jesus left the earth and went to heaven, he turned to his friends and he said, "I am coming back. I'm coming back, and when I come back, are you going to be ready for me? When I come back, will I still find people believing in me, believing in God when I come back?" And he told his disciples that they should be ready for when he comes back. So in church in Advent, we like to be ready. We like to prepare ourselves so that we're ready to celebrate at Christmas when Jesus came as a baby king, and to get ready for when Jesus comes back as the king of the whole world. And so we tell ourselves stories to help ourselves get ready. And the story that we tell on the first Sunday of Advent is a story you should remember from the last story boxes. A story about God calling his first families to be his people, and for God to love them and for them to love God. This is the whole big story of the Bible. God calls people to love him, and he draws them into his big family. He first of all called, do you remember the story, where he called Sarah and Abraham to be his family and his people, to follow him. And he said, "I'm going to bless you. And you, through you, I'm going to bless the whole world." That was God's special promise to them. And they had a son called Isaac. And Isaac married Rebecca. And they had God's special promise. And then they had a son called Jacob, who married Leah and Rachel. And they had children too. Lots and lots of children. And one of them was called Judah. And one of Judah's descendants also had God's promise to bless the whole world. And that was King David. And when King David was king, God said to him one day, David, one of your descendants is going to be a king on earth forever and will be a blessing to the whole world. And that descendant was Jesus. Jesus was one of King David's descendants, who was one of Judah's descendants, who was the son of Jacob, who was the son of Isaac and the son of Sarah and Abraham, God's special family. And now today, God's special family is everybody that God calls to join his special family. Jesus said the church is God's special family, because through the church, Jesus is going to bless the whole world, and the whole world will be blessed through the church. Isn't that an amazing promise? Right from the beginning of the Bible? It's a fantastic promise, and we are part of it. So this week, as we celebrate Advent Sunday and we light our first candle, it's a couple of things that you could do. Find out about an Advent wreath. See what you can find out for next week. And think about God's promise to the families, the first families he called, and to his family, the church. And think about, what's your place in that family? Shall we pray? Heavenly Father, thank you for your promises to us. Thank you for Advent Sunday and reminding us of your stories. Help us to get ready for you this Christmas by remembering you. Heavenly Father, help us in Jesus' name. Amen.